Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and today we're going to do a little Xamarin Forms 101. Today, we're going to be talking about command parameters. I previously did an episode about commands, so when your user interacts with something like a button, it will automatically call your code in the code behind. You probably want to go back and watch that video, and it's down there in the description, so give that a click first. Else, if you're ready to go, let's learn about command parameters. So like I said, a command is kind of simple. You click on something and it does something in your code behind. It's a mapping from I did this, go call this code. But often you may want to pass in parameters into it. So you actually may get something from a different control, or you may want to just simply pass in different data that maybe is bound in a property. So a good example of that is I might be entering my name and I want to use that as a parameter that is passed into query, for instance. And instead of creating a new backing field, you just pass it in as a parameter and you can pass that to the command. So let's take a look at a code to see how we can implement a command parameter really easily. So here I am inside of Visual Studio. Now this is my previous app, so it's a very simple little app that I can call to increase the count. And every time I tap it, it increases the count. If we look at the code here, I have a button that has a data binding to increase command, and then a label that will display count. When I look at the view model in the code behind, we can note that I have this increase command right here, which is an I command, and we've implemented a new command that here we'll call this method increase count. And when I do that, guess what? It increases the count and tells it to update the display count. Pretty simple. But now let's go ahead and update this. Let's say that we want to pass this a string of I, for instance, into here. And we may want to do something such as, hey, whenever I increase, we'll increase it by a different amount. So if int.tryParse, and I'll do I, and then I'll say out int 2. And if that's successful, then now let's go ahead and increase that here. So we'll say instead of plus plus, we'll say that count plus equals here int 2, since we're passing in a string. Now we'll notice that our command is very upset at us because it's no longer a void, it is taking in a string. Luckily, the Xamarin Forms built-in command is also parameterized. So here, instead of just a command, I'll say it's a command of string. So now it is expecting, if we look here, an action with string as the parameter type, which is super nifty. I don't even need to change the I command here. If I wanted to, I could say command substring if I was going to call that from the code behind. That's the same exact thing. It just maps. So you can think about what you want to do there. Now let's go into our main page and pass some information. So previously I was just calling the command and saying increase count, but here we'll say command parameter and we'll pass it 2. Now you may be wondering, well, how come I don't just pass an integer and why am I passing a string? Well, it's a good question. In general, each different control may pass different values, and by default, the object is going to be a string as that is parsed out. You could also use value converters or other items here if you wanted to, but we're just going to do the int try parse because that seems to work well for us. So now we have our display count. We're kind of good to go, and let's just go ahead and run this application again. Here again, we have that command parameter of 2. Going into my count here, we can go ahead and see we have the string command, passing it and try parsing it. And now we should go ahead and see the new application increasing by 2 every time. So here's our app that is started up. Give it a second here. There we go. So now we have increased count, and every time that I tap on it, we'll see that it increases to 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 2 every single time because it has now passed that parameter down. Now you may be saying, well, I might be calling this from my code behind. I don't have everything in XAML. Well, don't worry. If you're calling it from your code behind, you can still pass parameters. So for instance here, I have my code behind for my main page, and I'll just say VM, which is my main view model. And then I can say increase some command.execute. Now here, it's going to go ahead and say, what's your parameter? So I could say 3 here, for instance. And every time I could execute that from the code behind. There you have it, a little Xamarin Forms 101, passing parameters to your commands with just a few lines of code. Hope that you found this entry in the Xamarin Forms 101 mini-series helpful. Leave comments in the down below. Go and click some documentation links in the description. Make sure you hit that subscribe button on YouTube or Channel 9 to get the latest and greatest Xamarin show right in your inbox. Thanks for watching.